Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 5.2 in the sequencing model. We are discussing sequencing model. This is the second lecture in the sequencing model. The topic for the second lecture, again sequencing model. We have discussed the different sequencing model in the earlier lecture. And we solved problem in the processing n jobs in two machines. Now in this lecture we will be discussing processing n jobs in three machines, and we take problem solution procedure and the problem solving in the processing n jobs in the three machines. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the sequencing model. So processing n jobs in three machines. The assumptions: only three machines are involved, A, B, C are the machines, and as in the previous model, the each job is processed in the prescribed order A, B, C. So this is the order, or you can change even order B, C, A, but you have to define the problem properly. So when you prepare the sequence, before preparing the sequence, we have to define the order of processing the job. So A, B, C is the order, and the processing time for each job in the different machines. So for in the machine A, A1, A2, A3 up to AN, machine B, B1, B2, B3 up to BN, machine C, C1, C2, C3 up to CN. So this is the processing time. And the general solution for processing N jobs in three machines is not available. So Johnson established the procedure for processing N jobs in two machines. The same thing is extended with a slight modification in the problem, and we'll solve the N jobs in three machines with the extension of the problem solving technique for processing two N jobs in two machines. And here we have three machines. We have to convert the three machines problem into two machine problem by assuming equivalent machines, two equivalent machines G and H. So how to calculate the timing, process time in G and H? So it is the condition GI equal to AI plus BI and HI equal to BI plus CI. So the three machines are now converted into two machines G and H with the processing time as defined here, AI plus BI and HI BI plus CI. The condition is, so we cannot just arbitrarily select the condition. The condition is, so when the any one of the two conditions are satisfied, then only we adopt the method. So minimum time on A, machine A, should be greater than or equal to maximum time on machine B, or the minimum time on machine C should be greater than or equal to maximum time on machine B. So if any one of these two conditions are satisfied, then we can solve the problem N jobs in three machines with the problem solving technique for N jobs in the two machines. And we take up an example. With the help of an example, we try to solve the problem. The procedure is the same as we defined earlier. We have to identify the minimum time among the machines, and then we have to process the minimum job with minimum time in a particular sequence. Determine the optimal sequence of the job that minimizes the total elapsed time required to complete the following jobs, and find the total elapsed time. The job are processed in the three machines M1 and M1, M2 and M3 in the order M1, M2, M3. So there are seven jobs A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and there are three machines. The timings are given: machine 1, 3, 8, 7, 4, 9, 8, 7, machine 2, 4, 5, 2, 5, 1, 4, 3, and machine 3, 6, 5, 5, 11, 5, 6 and 12. Now we have to solve the problem to identify the total elapsed time and the sequence, the optimal sequence of the jobs. And the condition is satisfied, we have to verify. So the minimum time on the machine 3, minimum time on the machine 3 is 5. So look at the table, 5 is the minimum time on the machine 3, 5 hours, which is greater than or equal to maximum time on the machine 2. So maximum time on the machine 2 is 5 hours. So the second condition is satisfied, so we can proceed to solve the problem. Now the solution is obtained by taking two equivalent machines M4 and M5. So M4, M5, we calculate the time. The processing time of different jobs on the equivalent machines are calculated like this. M4i equal to M1i plus M2i. M5i equal to M2i plus M3i. So now the jobs are taken A to G and M1 M plus M2. The time M1 plus M2. The, in the previous table, we add the value 7, 13, 9, 9, 10, 12 and 10. And M2 plus M3, 10, 10, 7, 16, 6, 10 and 15. Now, we have to start the solution procedure. We have to identify the, examine the table. Minimum processing time is 6 hours for the job E, falls in the second column. So, this is the minimum time. Process the job last in the machine M4. So, now the order is M4, M5. First, the job is processed in the machine M4. Then, the job is processed in the machine M5. So, M4. Cross out the row E. So, this is the table. So, we take 7 column, 1 row and 7 column, and E is the job process in the last of the machine 4. Then delete the row. So, we delete the row and the remaining row is here. Remaining table is here. A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, F and G. Now, once again, examine the table. Examine the table, minimum time. You look at the table here, 7 is the minimum time. So, the 7 is the minimum time falling for machine job A, it is falling on the first column. For job B, it is falling on the second column. So, you take 7 and we take the process. So, this is falling on the first column. First, you have to process the job A. It is falling on the second column. In the last, already we have E. Now, C, job C is processed prior to E. So, A is in the first job and C prior to E. Now we delete A and C, the remaining table, 4 rows, 4 jobs are available now. So once again you verify the, you check the timing. So we have 9 is the minimum time. So we have all the, we have verified all the values, 9 is the minimum time. Now 9 is the minimum time which is falling in the first column. So already we have first column 1 job A, now D is processed after A. So A, and then we process the job D, then we remove the D, row D, and the remaining table is here. Now look at the table here. So the minimum time is 10 hours for all the 3 jobs. So for B and F, it is falling on the second column. For G, it is falling on the first column. So G, it is processed. So G, it is processed like this. So A, D already we have. G is processed after D. And B and F, we have same value in the second column. We can put anything. B and F or F and B. Whatever it is alright. So, we take B and F. Now, this is the sequence. A, D, G, B, F, C and E. This is the sequence of processing the job in the machine M1, M2 and M3. Now, we calculate the time. So, A, D, G, B, F, C, E. This is the sequence. And the machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, in and out time. For job A, the job A enters the machine 1 at 0 time, leaves at 3 hours, and again immediately enters the machine 2, leaves at 7 hours, immediately enters the third machine, leaves at 13 hours. Once the machine 1 is free after 3 hours, the next job is entering here. It is processed, leaves at 7 hours, immediately it goes to the second machine because it is available. Then the machine 2, it leaves machine 2 at 12 hours, but the job machine is not available. So, machine is busy with the previous job. So, it is available only 13th hour. So, in 13th hour, the job D is taken up by the machine 3 and it is completed by 24th hour. Job G is entering at the 7th hour, machine 1, machine 2, it is leaving by 14th hour, but it is waiting. So, because the job 1 is, machine immediately it is taken up. Immediately it will be taken up because the machine is free. So then it is processed in the machine 2. 17 hours it is leaving. It is leaving by 17 hour, but it is waiting because the machine is busy. So 24th hour the job machine is available. 24th hour it is taken up by the machine 3 and it is processed and leaving but 36 hours. Then job B is taken by 14th hour and it is leaving by 22nd hour. Now the machine is free, immediately it is taken up, machine 2 and it is processed and leaving at 27th hour. Now the machine is not free, machine is waiting, a job is waiting for the machine. So machine is available on the 36th hour and it is completed by 41 hour. Then job F, it is 22nd hour, the job F is taken by the machine 1. It is processed, leaving at 30 hours. Then the machine 2, it is leaving, entering at 30 hours, leaving at 34 hours. Now the job is waiting for the machine. So at 41 hour, the job machine is ready. So machine, the job immediately goes to the 41th hour and leaves at 47 hour. Then job C, it is entering by 30 hour, leaving by 37th hour, and entering the second machine by 37th hour, because the machine is waiting now. So because 34th hour machine is free, but the job is not ready. So 37th hour immediately it goes to machine 2, then machine, leaving the machine 2 by 39th hour, then it goes to the machine 3 by 47th hour and leaving by 52 hours. Finally, the job E, leaving, entering by 37th hour, leaving by 46th hour, then immediately it goes to the machine 2, 46th hour, leaving by 47 hour, and then it goes to the 52nd hour, it goes to the machine 3, and then it leaves by 57 hours. So the total elapsed time is 57 hours. Total elapsed time is 57 hours. Idle machine for machine 1. So machine 1 is completely busy. From the beginning it is busy. After 46th hour, it is waiting, because the cycle is completed only in the 57th hour. So here it is waiting for the machine idle for 11 hours. For machine 2, if you look at the machine 2, first 3 hours it is waiting. First 3 hours it is waiting. 7th hour it takes the second job. 12th hour the job is completed, but the machine is waiting for the next job. So here we have 2 hours. So because the job is not, this job is not ready, so it is waiting for 2 hours. Then again it is waiting for 17 hour it is completing for the second job. For the fourth job it is waiting for 22 hours. 27 hours it is completed, but the job machine is waiting for 30 hours, immediately it is taking the job. So here it is waiting for 3 hours. Then 34th hour it is completing, but the 37th hour only it is taking the next job. So 34, here again it is waiting for 3 hours. Then it is completed by 39 hours, again it is waiting. So 39 hour it is waiting for 46 hours. So again the waiting for 47, 46 to 41, 47 it is completed. From 47 to 57 it is again waiting. So waiting time for machine 2, so here 3 hours, so here 2 hours, here 5 hours, here 3 hours, here 3 hours. So here again 13 hours, so sorry, 7 hours, and from 47 to 57 we have 10 hours. So the total time is 3 plus 2 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 7 plus 10 equal to 33 hours. So machine 2 is idle for 33 hours, and machine 3 is idle for 7 hours, initial 7 hours. So initially, otherwise the machine is completely busy. So 13, 13, 24, 24, 36, 36, 41, 41, 47, 47, 52, 52, completely busy. So initially it is waiting for 7 hours. So this is all the idle time for different machines. And we take up another example, example number 4. A company has 4 jobs which must go through machines X, Y, Z in the order X, Y, Z. The processing time are given in the table. What should be the sequencing of the job? So there are 4 jobs with the 3 machines X, Y, Z. So the timing are 30, 120, 50, 20, and for Y 80, 100, 90, 60. For Z 140, 160, 150 and 120. Now we have to solve, find out the total elapsed time and the idle time for the machines X, Y and Z. And the condition is satisfied. So minimum time on the Z, minimum time on the Z is 120 hours. It is greater than or equal to maximum time on Y, which is 100 hours. So the condition is satisfied. We can proceed with the solution procedure. So the solution obtained by taking 2 equivalent machines G and H. So X, Y, Z is replaced by G and H. So G I equal to H I, X I and Y I, and H I equal to Y I and Z I. So the processing time of different jobs on the equivalent machines are calculated by the formula. Then the equivalent timing. So X plus Y, H, Y plus Z, the equivalent job 1, 2, 3, 4 and the processing time now 110, 220, 140, 80 and here H machine 220, 260, 240, 80. Now we solve the problem by identifying the minimum process time of different jobs. So first the job 4, the process time is 80 hours, which is falling on the first column. So 80 hours falling on the first column. So we prepare a table, single row with 4 cells. So job 4 is processed first in the machine G, and the row is removed. The row is removed and the remaining three jobs 1, 2, 3, 4 available. Now the minimum time is 110. So the minimum time is 110 now, which is again falling on the first column. So it is processed in the after job 1. After job 4, the job 1 is processed. So now the row 1 is deleted and remaining 2 and 3 is available here. Now the process time, minimum time is 140. So 140 is again falling on the first column. So it is processed after 1. So 4, 1, 3 is the order and it is removed now. So remaining job is only 2, which is processed in the order 4, 1, 3, 2. So the 4 jobs are processed in the order 4, 1, 3, 2. So the elapsed time we calculate. So 4, 1, 3, 2. So machine X, machine Y and machine Z. So at job 4 is entering machine X at 0 hours, leaving at 20 hours. Then it enters the machine Y at 20 hours, leaving at 60 hours. Then it enters at the machine Z at 80 hours, leaving at 200 hours. Now, job 1 is entering machine X by 20 hours, leaving by 50 hours. Then it is entering the machine Y at 80 hours, leaving at 160 hours. Entering machine Z at 200 hours, leaving at 340 hours. Then job 3 is next taken up, entering machine X 50 hours and leaving at 100 hours. Then it enters the machine Y at 160 hours and leaving at 250 hours. Then again enters the machine Z by 340 hours, leaving at 490 hours. Then job 2 is taken finally, enters at machine X at 100 hours, leaving at 220 hours. Then machine Y, it enters at 250 hours and leaves at 350 hours. Then machine Z, it enters at 490 hours and leaves at 650 hours. Now, the total elapsed time for the completing all the 4 processes in 3 machines is 650 hours. So, the total elapsed time is 650 hours. Then we have to find out the idle time for different machines. So, from 0 to 650, all the 4 jobs are completed in all the 3 machines. So, for the idle time for machine X, we have to calculate. So, look at here, machine X, 0 hour it starts. 20 hours, immediately take the second job, 50 hours, immediately take the third job, 100 hours, immediately take the fourth job and it completes by 220 hours. After 220 hours, till completion of the cycle, the machine is 3. So, 650 hours. So, 650 minus 220 is 430 hours, it is free. Machine Y, so initially it has to wait for 20 hours. So, first job is completed by 20 hours. So, it is waiting for 20 hours. Then 80 hours take the second job, completed by 160 hours. Third job is taken immediately, completed by 250 hours. Fourth job is taken immediately and completed by 350 hours. From 350 hours to 650 hours, it is again waiting. So, 220 plus 300 equal to 320 hours, machine Y. For machine Z, initially it is waiting for 80 hours. Initially, otherwise it is busy. Once it starts the job, it is busy. 200. It is next take this job immediately, 340. It is taking the job by immediately, 490. It is taking the job, fourth job immediately and it completes by 650 hours. So, for machine Z, the idle time is 80 hours. So, total elapsed time is 650 hours. Idle time for machine X is 430 hours. Idle time for machine Y is 20 plus 30, 300, 320 hours. Idle time for machine Z, 80 hours. So, to understand in a better way, we take another example in the processing n jobs in the 3 machines and here find the sequence that minimizes the total elapsed time in hours required to complete the following jobs in 3 machines. What is the minimum elapsed time? So, there are 7 jobs and 3 machines and the processing times are given 4, 9, 8, 5, 10, 9, 8 for machine 2, 5, 4, 3, 6, 2, 5, 4. For machine 3, 7, 8, 6, 12, 5, 6, 7, 13. So, we have to convert before converting into equivalent machine, we have to check the time and the condition is satisfied. So, what is the condition? Minimum time on the machine 3. So, minimum time on the machine 3 is 6 hours, which is greater than or equal to maximum time on the machine 2. So, maximum time here is 6 hours. So, the condition is satisfied. So, we can proceed with the solution method. So, the solution is obtained by taking 2 equivalent machines M4 and M5. The processing time for different jobs on the equivalent machines are calculated by M4 equal to machine 1 plus machine 2 and M5 equal to machine 2 plus machine 3. So, the equivalent timing, process time, it is taken M4 and M5, adding the M1 and M2, and here M2 and M3, the process time now 9, 13, 11, 11, 12, 14, 12. And here 12, 12, 9, 18, 8, 12, and 17. Now verify the processing time, check the processing time. Examining the processing menu table, the minimum time is 8 hours. So 8 hours it is falling on the second column. So when the value is falling on the second column, we ought to process the job 5 last in the machine M4. So it is processed here. We prepare the table, a single row with the 7 columns. So 5th job is processed last in the machine M4 and the 5th row is deleted. So after deleting the 5th row, so we will get the 6 jobs. So mentioned here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6 and 7. Now we examine the table again. So the minimum time is 9 hours. So for the job 1, it is falling on the first job, and for job 3, it is falling on the second column. For the job 1, it is falling on the first column. For job 3, it is falling on the second column. Now this is the timing available. Now the job 1, first column, so we have to process first in the machine M4. And 9, 3, we have to process prior to the 5. Now delete the 2 rows and remaining 4 jobs are mentioned here. Now once again examine the table, the minimum time is 11 hours. So 11 hours it is falling on the first column. For the job 4, it is falling on the first column. So already we have the job 1 in the first processing. Then after job 1, we have to process. So now 1, 4 and 3, 5 as it is. So job 4 is processed after 1. So delete the row 4 and the remaining table is here. Now the minimum processing time is 12. So the 12 is available for all the three jobs. So the 12 is available for all the three jobs. So 2 jobs, 2 and 6, it is falling on the second column. For 7, it is falling on the first column. So we have to process like this: 1, 4, 7, 2, 6, 3, 5. So the all the 7 jobs are processed in this order: 1, 4, 7, 2, 6, 3, 5. Now this is the sequence, optimal sequence, and we calculate the time. So the processing time. So this is the sequence: 1, 4, 7, 2, 6, 3, 5, and the machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, in and out times are calculated. So job 1 is entering 0 hours, completed by 4th hour, enters the machine 2 at 4th hour, leaves at machine 2 at 9 hours, then enters the 3rd machine at 9 hours, leaves at 16 hours. Then job 4 is entering 4th hour, leaves at 9th hour, entering the 2nd machine immediately, leaves at 15 hours, enters the 3rd machine 16 hours and leaves at 28 hours. Then job 7 is taken up, enters the first machine at 9 hours, leaves at 17 hours, immediately enters the second machine at 17 hours, leaves at 21 hours, then it enters at 28th hour in machine 3 and leaves at 41 hours. And job 2 enters at 17 hours, leaves at 26 hours, then it enters the next machine by 26 hours, leaves at 30 hours, then it enters at the 41 hour, leaves at 49 hour. Job 6 is next taken up, 26th hour machine 1, 35 hour it is leaving, then enters in the second machine immediately, then leaves at 40 hours in the second machine, and enters the third machine by 49th hour, leaves at 56th hour. Machine job 3 is taken up next, enters the first machine 35th hour, leaves at 43 hour, immediately it goes to the second machine 43 hour, leaves at 46th hour, then it is waiting, and it enters the machine 3 at 56th hour and leaves at 62 hours. Then job 5, it is taken up by 43 hour, and it leaves at 53 hour, immediately it is taken to the second machine, leaves at 55 hour, it is waiting, job is waiting for 62 hours, it enters the third machine by 62 hour and leaves at 68 hour. So this is the table, and we calculate the time, total elapsed time 68 hours. So 68 hours for all the job is completed, all the 7 jobs are completed in 3 machines by 68 hour. So total elapsed time is 68 hours. Idle time for machine 1, so first machine, so look at the time: 04, 49, 9, 17, 17, 26, 26, 35, 35, 43, 43, 53. So from 53 hours, it is waiting up to 68 hours, 15 hours it is idle. For job, for machine 2, so 4, first initially 4 hours, 9, there is no waiting time, 17, 15, 17, here it is waiting for 2 hours, 21, 26, here it is waiting for 5 hours, 30, 35, here it is waiting for 5 hours. 40, 43. It is waiting for 3 hours. 46, 53. Waiting for 7 hours. And 55 to 68, 13 hours. So the total time is 4 plus 2 plus 5 plus 7 plus 3 plus 7 plus 13 equal to 39 hours. For machine 9, machine 3, initially it is waiting for 9 hours. Then 16 immediately take the second job, 28 immediately take the third job, 41 immediately take the fourth job, 49 immediately take the fifth job, 56 immediately take the sixth job, 62 immediately take the next job, 68 it is completing. So initial waiting time 9 hours. So the total elapsed time is 68 hours and idle time for machine 1 is 15 hours, machine 2 is 39 hours and machine 3 is 9 hours. So these are all the answers to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and there is one book operations research. So you can refer to the book for additional problem in the sequencing model, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any help on the subject through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. We will meet again in another video lecture in the sequencing model. Until then, bye bye.